I don't think we've ever been up on level 1A before, level 1A right above us. This is where the motor is that operates the silent door, and it gets its energy from level 1C that we've shown you in a previous video. So let's go up and take a look at the big motor and see what else there is to see up there. Level 1A, close the hatch so nobody falls through. It's always bad for business. Okay, so level 1A is about the hydraulic motor that operates the silo door. It's actually two five-cylinder motors that are ganged together. They develop about 40 horsepower. And there's a drive shaft that runs from the motor to a pulley there and to a pulley over there, where there are wire ropes that go up through the ceiling and are attached to the underside of the door, so they pull the door open and close. And that's pretty much all there is to it. This is the silo elevator. The elevator doesn't actually come up here. You can open this gate, it's locked, but you can open this gate so you can have to go out and stand on top of the elevator car for maintenance purposes. But actually, the elevator does not come all the way up here. We can go up if you like and take a look at level 1D, which is about half a level above us here, where the elevator motor and the electrical box that has all the relays and stuff is up there. But before we do that, let's take a look out in the launch duct here, because this is a pretty cool view. Oh, it's a heavy door. All right, so this is the access level on level 1, and this would be used for maintenance people going out there and actually doing maintenance on the reentry vehicle. Oh, you have to watch your head out here. This is really, really tight. Plus, there's a big beam right here. You don't want to hit that. So kind of come out here and look over the platform, and whoa, there's the view looking down. And there's the view looking up. You can see the reentry vehicle right there. Now, just something I want to point out here that's kind of interesting. Take a look right here. See where it says gamma serial module? That's actually a prop that was put on when they filmed Star Trek here, and they forgot to remove it. So now it's an historic artifact.
Very careful coming out of here, so you don't hit your head. The reason you don't want to wear your hard hat out there is because invariably your hard hat falls off and falls to the bottom of the silo. So that's not a good thing either. Let's take a look at the other side of the motor right here. Be careful how you move around down here. So this is the other side of the motor, and this is the big pulley with the wire rope on it you see right here. And that goes, again, the wire ropes go up through holes in the ceiling and operate the door. So this is the ladder that goes up to level 1D. D is in delta, and that's where the elevator motor and control box is up there. So we can go up there and take a look. I'll just point out before we go that this is the only place I ever hit my head on the complex hard enough to draw blood. And that's because I was going up this ladder like an idiot. I didn't have my hard hat on. And I was leaning back a little too far, and I hit my head on the corner of that little beam right there. So don't do that. All right, here we go. All right, level 1D. I can't stand up straight. All right, I gotta watch these beams anyway. Take a look over the edge here, and you can see the pulley on the end of the motor. And some of the wire rope there, and a couple of little idlers, they call them, just position the cable precisely. The cables go up through these holes in the ceiling and connect to the underside of the door. And the reason that we have plugged the holes with those little pieces of wood is because a number of years ago, a rattlesnake dropped down through one of those holes and landed on level 1D. And we found it hiding under the elevator motor. And we could not coax it out or catch it or anything, so we just had to abandon him or her. And about 6 weeks later, the maintenance guys found a snake skin about this long down on level 6 of the silo. And how the snake got from here to level 6, I absolutely cannot explain, but that's what happened. And we never did find the snake that, like, presumably died from nothing to eat or drink. Didn't find anything, didn't smell anything. So someday, I suppose, somebody will be poking around in one of the dark corners of the silo and come upon a snake carcass. This is the elevator motor right here, and of course the cables. This is the overspeed detector, and the big black box is just where all the relays are. So when you punch a button in the elevator car or in one of the levels of the silo, it'll tell the elevator exactly, you know, where to go. And that's about all there is to see here. Oh, take a look over the other side. Here's the other pulley on the other end of the drive shaft. And if you look carefully on the top of the beam in the dust there, you'll actually see the trail that the snake made while it was crawling around on various pieces of equipment. All right then, so quick tour of levels 1A and 1D, and thanks for watching.